G'day there everyone, welcome back. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to do basic editing on the timeline, tell you what some of the shortcuts are, and also show you how to do very simple transitions. So you can do like a fade in and a fade out between two separate pieces of media. So let's get started by importing something to work with. To import media, make sure you're in the Project Media tab. Go to Import Media, and then look for where your video files are stored on your computer. This has just opened up at the last spot I was at, which is pretty normal. And I might just grab something else. Grab a seagull. And also grab some more puppies, that'll do. Now if I want to drag everything onto the timeline in one go, I can do the old trick of highlighting everything and dragging it down. Okay, just like that. That's a quick way. So what's the first thing you might want to do is learn how to split some video. So to do a split, click on top of the video, find exactly by scrubbing, that's called scrubbing, is when you move through your video trying to find a point. Find where you want to make your start point and press the S key, that splits it. And then if you want to delete this section here, just go right click, delete, and that gets rid of it. If you've made a mistake, you can press Ctrl Z to go backwards in time, like that, or you could have also have pressed the back arrow key up the top here. Another way that you can trim bits of film off, which is even faster than that method I just showed you, is to drag the edge of the film that you don't want. So this is going to be our start point. I'll go right to the edge of the film until that square appears. Hold the mouse button down and drag it. And as I'm dragging it, it's actually getting rid of all that first bit of film. It's not dragging the whole thing across the timeline, it's just dragging across the bit we don't want. Okay. Remember, if you want to zoom in, that you can use the roller on your mouse. Wherever that cursor is flashing is going to become the center point of the screen. So you can use the roller, you can use the plus and the arrow up and arrow down keys. You can even use the plus and minus button just there. There's another feature you can do. I'll just join some video together here and imagine that's how we wanted it to be. There's another feature you can use called Auto Ripple, and that's this little icon up here. Select that. And I actually call this the rubber band tool, because as soon as you press it, it puts an imaginary rubber band between all the bits of media, so that if you make a change between two pieces, once you've got rid of something, it snaps everything back. I'll show you what I mean. So if I want to get rid of some of this piece here, I'll do the drag method. I want to drag that away. Oops, now that grabbed hold of the wrong side. See how the square was on the other piece of film? I need to just move it across a bit. There we go. Now I'm going to drag that across because I don't want the end of that little bit there. And watch what happens when I let the mouse button down. Let the mouse button go. Everything moves to join back up again. So that's quite a handy little tool. Remember to click these things off when you're finished, otherwise you can get yourself into trouble thinking, what the hell's going on? One thing I did forget to mention, when you're doing normal editing, you've got to make sure that this button here, the normal edit tool, has been depressed. if it isn't depressed, you will lose your ability to do basic editing functions on the timeline. So always look to see that that's been engaged. What's next? Okay. We can copy media on the timeline really easily also. Say if this piece here, we wanted to create an identical duplicate of it. Simple way to do that, hold the control key down, put the mouse button on top, mouse pointer I should say, left mouse button down, and drag it across. And that has created a carbon copy. Let's add some text, because I want to show you this. If you want to add text to a project, click Media Generators, go to Text, drag that onto the timeline like that. Okay, so we've got our sample text there. Now, imagine that we wanted to copy this, make a carbon copy of some text we'd typed. We can hold the control button down again, left mouse button down, drag it across, let it go, and this time something different happens. A question comes up asking, do you want to create a new copy of the source media? Most, 99% of the time, you're probably going to go okay. So that is then turning that into a unique piece. So just remember that little question there to click OK. Another thing you'll notice on the timeline is when you go to butt something up against a new piece of film, often a coloured line appears, or the line lights up. Okay, that is called snapping, and that's being generated by this particular button up here, enable snapping. If that was turned off, that function stops. Okay, but if you turn it on, it's quite handy, because when you reach a point that you've chosen, it sort of puts the brakes on. And where it can prove to be really useful is stuff like this. Say if I wanted to line that up with the beginning of some text media, I'll drag this and watch what happens. Bang, see? Now there are also some different ways we can move pieces of media around the timeline. The obvious way is just holding the mouse button on top and just dragging it across, but you may want to select multiple pieces of media and move them all joined together. One way you can do that is hold the control button down and click on top of the pieces that you want to move all together. So let's go those four there and the text media that lies above the top. Let the control button go. Click back on top of one of the highlighted pieces. And now we can get everything to move as a whole group. Okay? Once you've reached the new position, just click outside the media. Everything's disengaged. And now you can go back to doing whatever you want. There is an alternative method to doing that, which is equally as handy sometimes, especially when your project's becoming quite complicated. Go up the top here and press the Selection Edit tool. Now, when you come down to the timeline, now we have a little rectangle appears. And what you want to do with this tool is draw a rectangle around all the pieces of media you want to move as one complete group. So hold the left mouse button down, draw out a square or a rectangle, let it go, click back on top, and then you can move it all away like that, let it go, click. Now after I've clicked and go back on top, nothing will move. It's now locked in place. To unlock it, we've got to go back up to the top and re-engage the normal edit tool. Now I'll go back down the bottom, and now everything's freed back up again. Okay. Now you might have noticed there by accident I jumped up one track, because that's a video track and that's also a video track. That's an easy mistake to fix. I can just click on top and bring it down, or I could do this. I could hold the control button down, select the pieces I want to move all in one go, let the control button go, and then drag them down in one big go like that. Click outside, everything's disengaged. Now, before this tutorial gets too long, I'm going to show you how to do a little transition. So we'll drag this up here like this, and I was going to zoom in on the timeline here. Whoops. Now that happened because it wants to zoom in wherever that's located. If I want a quick way to go to the front end of the project, just click that. Okay, now I'm going to click here. I'm going to zoom in, and this text media goes for just over 25 seconds. That's way too long. If I want to lengthen or shorten the period of time text appears on the screen, just drag the media along the timeline. So let's make that back to 10 seconds. Now I want to drag this all the way up here, and let's just change this. We'll call it just call it test project. Now with my test project, I would like to have the words fade in from black, then them fade out, and then everything fade in with the video. So how to do a fade in fade out is go to the top corner until that little quarter circle appears. Hold the left mouse button down and drag out that line there, okay? Go the other way till the quarter of a circle appears. Left mouse button down and drag across. Now I'll go back to the beginning and watch the previous screen, and that's a nice gentle fade in. Now you can do the same thing with the video. Hold that there. Let's do a 3 second fade in. And when you do a fade in for video, you have to treat the audio and the video component separately. So you have to fade in the sound as well. So do the same process there. We'll go here and see what happens. So that fades out, and then that fades in. But I would like to have a crossover between the media and the video. So just grab the video, shift it along like that. Now it's going to fade out the text and fade in the video. Watch what happens now. So the two crossfade at the same time. There is a different way you can do the fade in, fade out between two pieces of media, an equally valid method. Grab hold of the text and drag it down onto the same line as the video. Now we'll press play, and that automatically does a crossfade. And the final thing you might like to try is if you want to put a transition in, find from the transitions tab something you want to choose, grab hold of it with the left mouse button, drag it down to where the media overlaps, let it go, get rid of that, go back to the start there, click play, and there's your first transition. So thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and I'll catch you next time.